Today, I'm digging through an iPhone looking for a very particular material. We've talked a bunch on the channel about how different types of minerals and metals can end up in electronics like this one, and where they come from in the world. So there's gold, which conducts electricity really well. Lots of gold is mined in Nevada, Colombia, and China. Lithium, of course, is found in a lot of batteries, and lots of lithium comes from South America. But the material we're looking for is actually here. This is a tantalum capacitor. Or at least we think it's a tantalum capacitor. Apple makes it really hard to identify parts on their motherboard. But we found some schematics that pointed us in this general area.
Looks like it's right here.
It's a component that stores electrical charges. Tantalum is an element that's derived from an ore called columbite tantalite, or coltan. Tantalum is highly sought after because it's got a very high melting point and it resists corrosion. We wanted to get our eyes on this capacitor because the tiny scrap of metal inside has some huge implications. It's a piece of a complex web we've all woven between humans, nature, and resources. And now, in the middle of COVID-19, this web takes on an extra resonance because it could cause the next pandemic. That's a big claim, so let's break it down. A lot of coltan can be traced back to the Democratic Republic of Congo. Some comes from large industrial open pit mines, the kind of mine we're used to seeing images of. But most coltan actually comes from much smaller operations. This is often called artisanal or subsistence mining. It's often just people digging holes with shovels and picks to make a living. Subsistence mining means humans cutting their way through really remote areas. By clearing land to make way for mining, people interact with wildlife in ways they wouldn't otherwise. And that's where things can get messy.
Yeah, what we're talking about is spillover.
Our environment reporter Justine has been looking into all of this, and she'll take it from here.
So basically, when humans intermingle with wildlife, chances increase for something called a spillover event. This is when a virus jumps from one species to another. It's how most new infectious diseases emerge, including COVID-19. When one species bites, eats, gets pooped on by another, viruses from one species might infect the other. Artisanal mining offers up a lot of opportunities for spillover between animals and humans. To get some specifics, I called up Michael Nest.
Can you hear me okay? Can you see me okay?
He wrote an entire book about coltan, and he walked me through the details of how exactly one spillover event could happen.
You might not have much of a perimeter at all between a pit where somebody is mining and the forest itself. So people might go into the bush or rely on people who live in the forest to bring them food.
In this case, food is bushmeat. Wild animals hunted, killed, and eaten. In the DRC, bushmeat can mean a porcupine, rat,
a bush pig, or part of a gorilla.
It's a viable way for animal viruses to meet their first human host, and it happens pretty often. One study of miners working in the eastern DRC found that a majority of them relied regularly on bushmeat. They had no alternative.
If you are a poor mine worker and you get the opportunity to kill a gorilla and eat it because it's free meat, you're very likely to do that if you think you can get away with doing that.
And it's not just about bushmeat. Some animals might get drawn in closer by mining. Bats, for example, might take up residence in mines. That ups the odds of a miner getting scratched or bitten or exposed to waste. Other wildlife might get displaced. They might run into new groups of animals, and those interactions mean more chances for spillover.
So it's not just the access to bush food, but it's also that very close proximity to forests with very little attention paid to, you know, health infrastructure or public health.
So far, there hasn't been a major viral outbreak that we can trace back to coltan mining, but all the ingredients for spillover are there. It's a recipe for another pandemic. And it has happened around other mines. An outbreak of Marburg killed 128 people in the DRC between 1998 and 2000. Marburg is a viral hemorrhagic fever, similar to Ebola. Most of those who died were gold miners who probably picked up the virus from bats or other critters in mines and then spread it to their families. And in 1994, 31 people died from outbreaks of Ebola in gold mining villages in Gabon. Scientists suspect that the virus could have jumped from chimpanzees to humans. And if you take the widest possible view, you see that there are hotspots all over the world where new infectious diseases are emerging. In many of those cases, It's happening where people are clearing land for things like mining, logging, and agriculture. Because of COVID-19, there's been a lot of talk about China's wet markets, where researchers initially thought the virus made the jump from animals to humans. But the journey of this phone's minerals shows that the threat of spillover is so much bigger than just one scenario.
Everybody's talking about the wet markets and so on, but that's just the, really, literally the tip of the iceberg, really.
Carlos Zambrano Torrelio is a scientist at EcoHealth Alliance, a nonprofit that works to spot animal viruses before they spill over into humans. He says we need to think about the connection between our demand for electronics, the destruction of habitats, and the consequences.
Pretty much every year there's a new iPhone. We should remember that it's coming from somewhere in the world. And then there is a whole chain that it's been affected.
Since 2009, EcoHealth Alliance, in partnership with USAID, found 1,200 viruses in animals, including more than 140 new coronaviruses that could one day pose another global threat. They'll continue to study the virus's behavior, but virus behavior depends a lot on human behavior. There's no getting around it.
We need to start thinking about the future as a whole, as humanity, you know, as the planet, how we want to deal with this problem. Do we want another pandemic 10 years from now, next year, in the 50 years from now?
The next pandemic will almost certainly come from some spillover in a viral hotspot. And that really shouldn't come as a surprise.
Usually humans, we see ourselves outside the system, but we are really part of the system. The reason that we share most of the diseases with animals is because we are animals. We are part of the animal kingdom.
Thanks so much for watching. If you want to see more of our COVID-19 coverage, check out theverge.com. And don't forget to subscribe.